Hi, I'm Nathan Hillson, and I'm the overall principal investigator of the U.S. Department of Energy's Agile BioFoundry. In this webinar, I'll be providing a brief overview of the Agile BioFoundry. The overall goal of the Agile BioFoundry is to enable biorefineries to achieve 50% reductions in the time it takes them to scale up their bioprocesses compared to the current average of around 10 years. We'll be doing this through establishing a distributed Agile BioFoundry that productionizes synthetic biology. The outcomes of the Agile BioFoundry will include the development and deployment of technologies enabling commercially relevant biomanufacturing of a wide range of bioproducts by both new and established industrial hosts. The relevance of the Agile BioFoundry is that it's a U.S. $20 million per year public infrastructure investment that increases U.S. industrial competitiveness and enables opportunities for private sector growth and jobs. One way that we like to talk about the Agile BioFoundry is through an analogy with public transportation. Shown on the screen is an image that we adapted from Lyft, in which the dark lines indicate public transportation, and shown in pink might be those of private transportation. The idea being that if a passenger wants to go in a particular place, they might be able to use a bus or a subway to get to fairly close to where they want to go, say, for example, a city center. But they might still need to take a rideshare like Lyft or a bike or walk to get to their final destination, which might be a restaurant or their place of residence. So the Agile BioFoundry thinks of itself in a very similar way, where one of our collaborating companies or academic partners might want to go somewhere in biochemical space. The Agile BioFoundry enables them not to have to reinvent the wheel, and in their organism of choice can help them get to fairly close to where they want to go. However, it is the company or the academic partner that chooses the final destination. And also, the company or academic partner is retaining the very valuable intellectual property of that last mile getting from the public infrastructure of the Agile BioFoundry to their final commercial product. So this is a reasonable analogy that we like to talk about in ourselves. In an additional webinar from the Agile BioFoundry, you'll be hearing about our beachhead molecules and how that relates to this particular analogy. The Agile BioFoundry is distributed across the U.S. at 7 different national labs: Berkeley Lab, Sandia National Lab, Pacific Northwest National Lab, the National Renewable Energy Lab, Los Alamos National Lab, Argonne National Lab, and Oak Ridge National Lab. And together, we form the Agile BioFoundry. This is very important because it enables us to leverage investments that the Department of Energy has made at the National Lab over the past decades, as well as the domain expertise that's distributed across our country. We're developing the science and technology that empowers bioprocesses for things like fuels or chemicals and materials, and these bioprocesses can get distributed across the U.S. at various biorefineries. In addition to the bioprocesses themselves, we're also developing a number of technologies or methods or software. And importantly, all of these technologies, methods, and software can either be available from us or off the shelf as commercial products, which means that if any company or academic collaborator works together with us and they like the methods we're using, the software, the technology, the automation, it means that that company or that academic can bring those technologies into their own company, into their own lab, behind their own firewalls, so that they can then operate the same way that we do by themselves. That's a key differentiator compared to some of the private BioFoundry offerings that are out there. Now, the Agile BioFoundry, as we mentioned, one of its key goals is to reduce the time to scaling up. So in our first 3 years of operations, we were only supporting 5 different industrial hosts. And this was our baselining, where it took on average about 10 years to develop a new bioprocess at a cost of about $100 million. In our current 3 years, we're currently at year 5, we're going to be developing up to 20 different microbial hosts and starting to reduce that bioprocess development to scale up time down to 8 years and at a cost of $50 million. And then we anticipate to be the final 3 years of the Agile BioFoundries project will be going up to 50 microbial hosts, reducing that commercialization timeline by 50% down to 5 years and reducing it to a cost of $25 million. The Agile BioFoundry contains 6 overall tasks. We have task 1, design, build, test, learn. So it's really an integrated engineering cycle for biology with automation. Our second task is integrated analysis. And this is where we do our life cycle analyses and our techno-economic analyses. In our third task, we have host onboarding and development, where we bring in new industrially relevant host organisms into our Agile BioFoundry and continue to develop those that have already been onboarded. Our fourth task is to integrate our processes and to scale them up. This would include, for example, producing our hydrolysates, as well as scaling up our fermentations. Our fifth task is industry engagement and outreach. And our sixth task is our management task. The Agile BioFoundry's organizational chart largely follows its task structure. It's worth pointing out that our BTO technology manager is Jay Fitzgerald. The Agile BioFoundry does have an executive committee and an industry advisory board, as well as quite a few industry partnerships. And I'll be talking about those on a later slide. The overall approach to the Agile BioFoundry largely is as follows. On the left-hand side of the slide, we see the targets that our collaborators might be choosing. Or internally, we might be choosing in strategic beachhead molecules, which you'll hear about in a subsequent webinar. Once those targets are identified, we can go through the core engineering biology cycle of design, build, test, and learn. It's important to point out that the Agile BioFoundry, through its integrated analysis task, does offer support in terms of techno-economic analysis and life cycle analyses, and you'll be hearing about that in a subsequent webinar. We do have host onboarding and development, as I mentioned, and you'll also be hearing about that in a subsequent webinar. Down on the bottom right, we do have the capability of scaling up to 1,000 liter scale. You'll be hearing about those efforts also in a subsequent webinar. And on the bottom of the slide, we have lots of capabilities around test, so things like proteomics, metabolomics, as well as learn, which could be mechanistic modeling as well as machine learning and artificial intelligence. You'll be hearing more about our testing and learning capabilities in a subsequent webinar as well. The Agile BioFoundry has quite a few existing collaborations with industry and academia, and largely these are supported in part by one of two means. So the Agile BioFoundry in fiscal year 2017, as well as the current year, fiscal year 2020, the Agile BioFoundry had a directed funding opportunity where companies or academics could write proposals for research with us, and all of the research and development effort on the Agile BioFoundry side would be supported by the Department of Energy. In fiscal year 2017, we did have one of these directed funding opportunities that included 6 companies and one academic group. And in the current year, fiscal year 2020, there are 7 companies and one academic group that we're going to be working with. In fiscal year 2018 and 19, the Department of Energy issued a funding opportunity announcement, and these supported in fiscal year 18 2 companies and one academic group, and in fiscal year 19 2 different academic groups. In summary, the overall goal of the Agile BioFoundry is to enable biorefineries to reduce the time it takes them to develop and scale up their bioprocesses. The outcomes of the Agile BioFoundry are to develop and deploy technologies enabling commercially relevant biomanufacturing of a wide range of bioproducts by both new and established microbial hosts. And the relevance of the Agile BioFoundry is that it's a U.S. $20 million per year public infrastructure investment that really increases our U.S. industrial competitiveness, enables opportunities for private sector growth and jobs. Thank you very much for your attention, and I do hope that you'll be able to see our subsequent webinars on topics such as host onboarding and development, integrated analysis, scale-up, as well as our test and learn capabilities.